I'm Alexander Gray. My company is called Somaxis, and we make a open source electrophysiology sensor called the MyoLink. I'm wearing it here. You can wear it on your head and it measures EEG, or you can put it on your heart and it measures your heart rate and heart rate variability, or you can put it on other muscles in your body and it can measure muscle energy and activation. So it can give you live alarms when your stress or tension levels are too high. Say if you're at the workplace and you are working on your keyboard or your mouse and your muscle levels are elevated, it'll give you tones and live feedback to tell you that your stress levels are too high. You can have live alarms for when your heart rate variability is too low. It can indicate to you when you're losing focus. So if you're falling asleep at the wheel of your car, for example, it'll actually give you some alarms to wake you up. There's also active training programs to teach people how to retrain their stress response. So you can actively learn how to interrupt the process that goes from psychological stress to physical tension. So you can work for longer periods of time at your desk or whatever and not experience the physical symptoms that tend to accompany that kind of intense psychological pressure. You basically just need to either have a smartphone of some type, either Android or iOS. You don't have to have a smartphone though. It'll also just record the data on the device and give you that feedback, so then you can sync it up later with your computer. And if eventually we reach our funding goals, we'll have onboard feedback on the device itself. So you could use it totally and have live feedback, but use it without your smartphone. We are looking for angel investors or anything we can do to basically get to our goals. So our minimum goal when we eventually launch Kickstarter is going to be, Indiegogo, is going to be about 50,000. But we have stretch goals at about 100 and 200K. And if we hit those, then we'll add an onboard accelerometer so that you can do activity tracking and onboard feedback with a little mini speaker and things like that. So the go-forward plan is to basically launch our campaign and start focusing on making a really robust platform that we're going to bring to production. And this is an open source platform, so we're going to release it with some software, with some applications in mind. But ultimately, we really want to encourage the developer community to get engaged and to look at other kinds of applications such as sports and fitness, workplace safety monitoring, video games, prosthetics controllers, robotics. There's all these different areas that we want people to go in. There's an API. Yeah, not an SDK quite yet. We're trying to get there. There's about six of us, and we're based out of the Bay Area. We're in the South Bay. We'll definitely sell to everybody. I think this is something that everybody could benefit from. We are building everything here locally in California, though, so we are insourcing all of our manufacturing. We are strongly committed to making everything. Right now, we're doing everything through tech shop and making it in our garages. Eventually, we'll scale it up a little bit, but still keep everything local. I think there's different demographics. If, you know, in athletics and fitness, it's, you know, anyone from, you know, I don't know, 15 to 85 who is interested in getting into shape or being in shape. In terms of stress and retraining, anyone that really is experiencing a great deal of stress, and this can be people that work either in front of a computer or doing manual labor or anything. I think we have a pretty broad demographic. We want to make something with a really, really smooth UI, make the feedback mostly audio so that anyone, regardless of skill or experience level, can use this thing right out of the box and just put it on and get meaningful information that helps them sort of reduce their stress and tension levels wherever they are. So I met Dave at the Quantified Self Conference at Stanford, and he was really excited about this. He released an article a while ago where he was talking about the top 10 hacks that people can do to really improve their lives. And I don't remember what the number was, but number three or four on the list was buy an SEMG system, which is a muscle feedback system. Unfortunately, the caveat was they typically cost about $10,000. So we make that. We make a muscle feedback system for SEMG biofeedback, except for it costs $100. So we're really trying to take this technology, which has so many benefits, and put it into everybody's hands. I think it's a different kind of business model. When you want to make all your money back in hardware sales, you're going to price it in a certain way, and you're going to expect to get that margin back in the first 1,000 units or 10,000 units or whatever it is. We, at the end of the day, we're a hardware platform, but we're not really intending to make money from a very small number of sales. We want this to be a sensor which everyone can afford. So we're also willing to take a smaller margin, a smaller cut, because we're going for a larger volume play. We think that this is a sensor that lots and lots of people will find useful and interesting, especially if we hit our extra goals and manage to put on an accelerometer and some of these other bits inside it. It really has the potential to replace a lot of other devices out there at a fraction of the cost. So our website is somaxis.com, S-O-M-A-X-I-S. If anyone's interested in getting more information, you can email me directly, agrey, at somaxis.com. Love to hear from you, whether you're a user or developer. We have lots of information. We're very, we don't have a hierarchy. We're all just kind of working here at the same level to create a good product. So love to hear from anyone that is interested in getting in touch with us. Thank you.